Welcome to weekly vlog 35. It's actually Monday and I haven't started the vlog. I didn't get a chance to do anything yesterday.
Lies.
It's not lies. It's not lies at all. But starting the vlog on an exciting note, we've just been to look at a house and we have applied for it. Two other people have also applied for it, so we don't know if we'll get it or not, but it's really, really nice. So yeah, cross everything. Hopefully by the end of this vlog we'll know whether we've got it or not. What are you doing? Have you not locked your car? He hasn't locked his car, so I'll just chat to you. At the end of this vlog we will probably know if we got the house or not, but it's really, really cute. The second bedroom is a bit small, but that's fine. We're just gonna make it like an office room instead. I kind of wanted a guest room, but I think I'm gonna have to compromise on that because everything that we've looked at so far, the second bedrooms are tiny. Did you lock it? And it's just a courtyard garden, but we don't need a garden, so we don't really go in the garden. Now we are going to Bill's to go have some lunch. It's actually our anniversary tomorrow, and I'm really bad actually working tomorrow, and Dan booked the whole week off, so bad girlfriend points. So we're going to go to Bill's now. And I'm very excited. I haven't actually been to Bill's for a really long time. Really long time. When was the last time you went to Bill's?
Smithy?
Yeah.
With Mel.
Years ago.
Yeah, a few years ago.
It's very exciting. Don't know what I'm going to have yet. Well, it's turned into a very miserable day. It's so wet and horrible. It was lovely when we left the house. I've just got home because Daniel's got a work meeting, so, and then I think he's playing darts or something tonight, so I've come home anyway. I think I might try and sort my hair out and maybe film a video. Don't know what to film though. I need to have a little think, but it's been like 2-3 weeks since I've had like a main video as well as the vlog, and I'm feeling really bad. I feel like I'm slacking. So yeah, I might do that, or I might not. We'll see what happens. See whether I can think of something to film. But yeah, I keep thinking about like how I'm gonna furnish this house, and I need to stop because we might not even get it. Because I think we're we were the last people to view it and the third people to apply. So I really don't think we're gonna get it. But you never know. You never know. I really need a wee. I'm gonna go have a wee.
Good evening, lovies. I've spent my afternoon very unproductively and not to plan. I was planning on being productive and starting to go through like these shelves and stuff that's on my bedside tables and go through all the books that are on there and sort them out and stuff, but I didn't. I've been watching YouTube. I did, however, notice anything missing there. Finally, I cleaned the hamster cage out, so that is away in its box again, and it's in the loft. I don't know whether to sell it or to keep it, because I don't know whether I want to get another hamster at some point or not, so I'm gonna keep it in the loft here and decide that at a later date, because it took me a long time to clean it out, let alone like decide whether to sell it or not. But yeah, I'm just gonna sort myself out, get my jammies, get comfy and get ready for Broadchurch, because it's Monday, which means Broadchurch night. Very exciting. So that is my plan, basically.
Hello loves, how is your Tuesday going? I'm still waiting for a phone call from the estate agent. Still waiting. He called me this morning and I got all excited, and then he was like, oh, I'm just calling to let you know that I can't get hold of the landlady. I was like, okay, thanks. That was at like 9:45, and it's now 2:05, and I'm still waiting. But I thought I would show you because it's Hannah's birthday this weekend, and she's going to have opened these by the time this vlog goes live, because I know she watches. Hi Hannah, happy birthday, hope you had a good birthday. I thought I'd show you what we've got her. So she's getting married this year, so we thought we would get her like some nice makeup for her to use. So we got her a Naked Urban Decay flushed palette in Nuna, because obviously she's getting married in Zante, so she's gonna have a tan, so we're like, we can't get her one that's suitable for her, like perfect for her paler skin, but she can use this one with a tan and without a tan, so it's more like a corally blush and stuff. So hopefully she likes that. And we also got her the Elizabeth Arden 8-hour cream lip protection stick, because with SPF 15, because that's gonna be perfect when she's away in the sun. It'll protect her lips and stuff, and also the Elizabeth Arden 8-hour cream in any consistency, is that the right word? Any format, however it comes to you, is amazing. So we picked up that for her as well. So hopefully she likes those. I'd be very happy with those. In fact, I really want the lip protection stick. I really want that. Oh, also, we got the Yellow Pages posted through the door this morning at work. When did the Yellow Pages become like super skinny? There's nothing like on it, unless this is just like a business Oh, this is just the yellow pages for local businesses. I get it. I'm there. Oh, yes. Yell.com businesses. Well done, Cara. Well done. I just had a baguette from Pret, a tuna and cucumber one, and also their banana loaf, because I really like banana loaf. Hate bananas, like banana loaf. It was really, really good. Really good. That was my naughty payday lunch. My lunch is pretty much nearly done. Today's going pretty quick. It's already 2:05. It's going really quick. Long may that continue through today and tomorrow. Then I'm off again on Thursday. Yay! I fell asleep during Broadchurch last night, and I woke up about 5 minutes from the end. So then I was like, I'll rewind it. So I took it back to, because I watched it on catch up. I took it back to where I remembered, and then I fell asleep again. So I need to rewatch that again. But what I watched was really good. Hello, lovelies. It's been a while. In fact, like, we've missed the whole day. It's Thursday now, and I'm actually at a John Lewis event, which is pretty exciting. Look. So recently, the John Lewis in Cambridge opened up a new, like, beauty court. They redid it all. There's loads of new brands. It's really, really big. It's beautiful in here. I could literally live in here. It's insane. And so they're having like a little vlogger YouTube event, which is really, really lovely. We've got a little goodie bag. I haven't looked through mine yet, so I don't know what that is. Here's a little munchkin.
Like, I don't know what's going on with my head.
This light is not the most flattering light.
No, it's not.
It's really
we're
not.
Above one, that's why.
Oh. Okay. I feel like we're always going to be above one, though.
Yeah. Vlogging, I was like, I've got to go.
You have to join in. Everyone goes to
I'm not vlogging for a change.
Yeah, you're not vlogging it. You should have vlogged it. You need to start weekly vlogging.
No.
Yeah. Everyone tells Sophie she should weekly vlog.
No.
You should. Where have you been? Have you been anywhere yet?
Nowhere. No.
I need to just have a walk around, I think.
Yeah.
We were just saying we should have come with no makeup on. They could have done our makeup.
Yeah. Well, maybe we could take it off and redo it.
That's a good point. It's time to have a walk around.
Show I look after everything that is fashion, so everything in the basement, the beauty hall and this floor. So welcome to John Lewis Cambridge. So it'd be good to know a bit about what you do actually.
So my name is Alice Toby Brandt, and I have a blog which I've had for like 7 years, and I also run the Instagram account for Independent Cambridge.
Okay.
And it's a lifestyle blog, so it's like beauty and fashion and anything I just decide to talk about really.
My name's Jemima, I'm a portrait photographer and part of the group. So
okay,
so
it's great.
People.
I will.
Thank you. I'm Gemma, I'm a freelance fashion writer, I have a fashion blog. All things fashion, that's it really.
I've been lusting after your bag.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
I did that as well. I feel good.
Let's get a close up of the bag.
An amazing bag.
Well, I'm Becca, I work in Women's Wear. I have my own lifestyle blog. I'm actually leaving soon, so I was keen to get you all to know about like John Lewis so you can get involved.
Yeah, Becca's why we're all here basically.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so hopefully once I leave we can all still get involved with John Lewis because it'd be great.
Yeah, definitely.
I'm Sophie, I do YouTube and I blog about lifestyle, fashion, travel, a bit of everything.
Okay.
Nice.
I'm Lily, I do beauty blogging maybe.
Started
John Lewis.
Ah,
yeah, so kind of take over from me.
Fantastic, yes, right.
I'm Jennifer, I'm an interior designer and I have an interiors blog, and I'm also an event director for a kind of design event.
Okay, great. Hi.
I'm Kat, I work as a personal stylist, about kind of encouraging people's confidence through their clothing.
Okay.
And I write a column for Cambridge News and City Life as well.
Launched it yesterday, so it's in Grazia this week. There's a double page spread in Grazia if you haven't
we don't have any photos today.
Part of the shop fit is actually downstairs, so you'll see it when you're downstairs. But it's basically our, so it's a new lifestyle brand for us, built predominantly around denim. And the denim's all made in LA, and it was designed by two designers who were with Levi's for a long time. So so it is a, you know, a John Lewis brand, but what we're trying to do is build really strong identity within our own brand assortment. So so yeah, so this literally launched yesterday. So feel free to
have a look. John Lewis go for this brand over other denim brands?
So we wanted to do something that's our own denim, but that is that will stand up against Levi's, all of that, but have an access point that's more, I guess, high street than something like Sevenfold, Mankind, and all of that stuff.
What sort of price range are we talking?
So all of these are 85, so they're the same price as a pair of Levi's. So all made, as I say, all made in LA. And then there's other pieces built around it. So,
yeah. The jeans kind of the main focus.
So the jeans is the main focus.
I'm just saying, the lighting in here is shocking for like filming. I feel like my skin looks dreadful. I don't know if I explained it properly why we were here, because I was interrupted about boot love. Yeah, they basically brought us. They basically brought us up here, all like the blogging people, because I think it's a big event anyway, so there's lots of other people here that have been invited that aren't bloggers and stuff. But they brought us up here to come and look at their new range. So as you just heard, it's basically John Lewis' own range with lots of denim and things like that. There's such gorgeous pieces in this collection. It's beautiful. So many pieces that I really like. I've just bought a leather jacket as well that I'm kind of, oh my goodness, look at this. Oh my goodness, that's so soft. That's like the softest leather I've ever felt in my life. It's so nice. Oh, this is exciting. Look at the sleeve. Look at the sleeves. Oh, that's so cute. I need to put this in my bag. Lovely, and it was so nice to see all the girls again and to see some people that I've talked to on Twitter but not actually like met in person. It was really nice to actually meet them. So if I spoke to you at the event, it was so lovely to meet you, and if I already knew you, it was lovely to see you again. I had so much fun. Also, now I need to go find Daniel, because Daniel was really sweet and brought me in and he's taking me home. So I need to go and find him, and I think he's just driving around Cambridge waiting for me to come out. So I'll speak to you when I get home. I thought I would show you what I've got in my little goodie bag, because I always love to see what's in people's goodie bags. Hello, baby. So we got a few perfume samples. We've got a YSL La Homme one, which I haven't actually smelled. I sprayed a YSL one on myself. Hang on, what was it called? I sprayed Black Opium Floral Shock from YSL, and kind of in love with it and really, really tempted to go and buy it for myself, because as soon as I got in the car, Daniel smelt it as well, and he mentioned it, and he doesn't normally mention like my perfumes. So we've got a few others. So we've got, not gonna try and like pronounce them, I'm just gonna show you. So we've got that one, and I've got another one. Hold up, there you go. So from that one, I haven't smelled any of them, so I don't know. We got two little samples, Focus on Me. Two little samples from Charlotte Tilbury. They're lipstick samples, by the way, but I don't know what colour they are. It doesn't say anywhere, so that's annoying, but they're the same. I've got the two of the same colour. Looks like a really nice colour, actually. We've got a Living Proof Healthy Hair Nightcap, like an overnight hair mask, which is lovely. I am a massive fan of anything hair and hair mask related, as I'm sure you all know from watching the vlogs. We've got a Rituals
Body cream, love Rituals. That smells so nice as well. It's the organic rice milk and cherry blossom. It's lovely. We've got a little sample of the Clinique High Impact Mascara, which I actually have the full size of and I've used before, but this will be really nice to travel with, like if I'm away anywhere. We have got a... it's called a wedding mask, but I think it's like an overnight mask. Yeah, so you put it on overnight. It's an Aveda mask. You all know how much I love Aveda. So when I saw this, I got quite excited, I'm not going to lie. Really like that. And this was like the top one for me. It's a MAC Prep and Prime sample. This is something I've wanted to try for a really, really long time. But I never really go into MAC and I don't really wear a lot of MAC. If anything, I don't wear MAC makeup anymore at all. I used to wear it a lot. The only thing I wear now is their lipsticks if I really want to, but I haven't bought myself one for a while. I have moved on to Charlotte Tilbury, I'm not gonna lie. But this is something that I always wanted to try, so I'm actually really excited that I've got that in the little goodie bag, which is really sweet, a little goodie bag. But yeah, like you saw, they took us up to their new clothing range, and there is a pair of shoes in that clothing range that I am in love with. I didn't film them for some unknown reason. I didn't show you them. I really should have, but I got too excited about it. But they may have to be a little treat to myself next time we get bonus, which I have no idea when that is gonna be, but they may have to be a treat for bonus, if and when bonus ever happens. But they were beautiful. They were like brogue type shoes. They were orange suede leather. With like a tiny little heel, brogue style shoe with cut out sides. Oh my goodness, they were so beautiful. They were £75, which is actually not that bad, but yeah, kind of in love with those. If I get a chance to, I might pop into John Lewis tomorrow, so I'll show you them tomorrow if I can without looking like an absolute weirdo. I should have just filmed this day. I have no idea why I didn't. I just got a bit excited because some of the other... Have I got a bruise? No, it's shadow. Some of the other girls were trying stuff on and I was like, yes, just buy it. So they bought some stuff, but my payday is tomorrow, so I couldn't buy myself anything, which is very frustrating. Don't do an event the day before payday. It's just unwise. I also should have picked myself up a Charlotte Tilbury lip liner, which is something that I've been wanting to pick up for a while, but I completely forgot. I got distracted by everything else that was going on. But it was such a lovely event and I really hope that they do another one. They invite us bloggers all along again because it was a really nice night and it was really nice to catch up with all the girls and meet some new faces and meet some people that I've talked to on Twitter but haven't met, that sort of thing. So yeah, it was a really, really nice night. But I am now exhausted. I've already in my pyjamas, well, bottoms, in my stars. And I need to eat something, but I think I'm probably just going to have a bowl of cereal because... What's the time? No idea. 9:30. It's 9:30, so this is definitely a male fragrance. So yeah, I'm gonna go have a bowl of cereal and snuggle up with this little one and watch some Netflix, I think. Go watch some Netflix? Yeah. I love her. Oh, house update while we're here. I've been talking to you for 6 minutes, but I'm sure you'll continue. Daniel phoned the estate agent yesterday and basically the guy that we were dealing with is now on holiday, which is fine. So we spoke to someone else and he said that the landlady has basically said that she hasn't picked anyone, like she wants to continue to keep viewings happening, but that he was going to call her and find out a bit more. And then he called me this morning, or this afternoon, and basically said the landlady wants to keep viewings open for another 2 weeks, even though there's like 3 people that have applied for this house. He said it was very unusual for landlords to do that, and I was like, it makes me kind of nervous that she's nervous, if that makes sense. Does that make any sense? But like, we're really keen on this house and I feel like she's not happy with the people that have applied, so she doesn't want us to have the house, which makes me kind of nervous. But I guess we'll see what happens, but cross your fingers and everything for us guys, because I really like this house and so does Daniel, and it's like a prime location. And yeah, I don't know if it's going to happen, but if it doesn't happen then it's not meant to be and we'll find something else, I'm sure. But yeah, I do really like this house. But that's where we're at the minute. We're just waiting for a phone call from the estate agents to say that the landlady's actually made her decision. But I don't think we're going to hear anything for another week because she wants to keep viewings open for like another 2 weeks, which is very annoying. But I guess the house isn't available until the end of April anyway, so it's not the massive problem, but it is frustrating because we don't really know where we are, so we're still viewing other places, but knowing that this one could come up, we're a bit like, do we still apply for something else? Like, what if we get given something else and then 2 weeks later she comes back and she's like, oh, actually, yeah, you can have it. Like, we don't get our money back from fees and stuff. It's very frustrating. So I don't really know what to do at the moment. But I will keep you updated with the situation. Good evening. I ordered a jumpsuit today. I've basically got a party birthday do bash thing to go to in April. And I literally don't think I have anything to wear, so I ordered this jumpsuit and it's literally bargain of the century. Hold up, let me find it. It's from New Look and I actually saw it, I'll explain why I'm trying to find it. I actually saw it like last week when I got those boots, that's when I saw it. Excuse me. And I picked it up and I looked at it and I really, really liked it and it's the sort of thing that I wanted to wear. But for some reason, I put it back down and like walked away and left it. I don't know why, but I did. Cheer. And I was looking online with Zoe today at work to try and find something and it came back up and there was only size 8 available. Now there's only a size 10 available. And so I ordered it because I was like, this is fate, like I need this in my life. It's this, hold up. How cute is that? And I really like it because it's going to cover up, I hate the top of my arms. So it's going to cover up the top of my arms. And I've never worn clots before, so we'll see. So I need to find some shoes to go with it. Right now, I'm just really hoping that it fits. Because it's a size 8 and New Look things kind of fit me kind of odd. Like sometimes I'm a 6, sometimes I'm an 8, and sometimes I'm like closer to a 10. Like it completely depends on what I'm wearing and stuff. So I really hope it fits. It should be there on Sunday. So you'll see it in next week's vlog. But yeah, I really hope it fits. It's so nice. I really, really like it. I ordered a different one at the same time as well. So it's a lot more like casual. This one was $22.99, but I think I'm going to prefer the burgundy one. But this is still really nice. Like, it looks really, really comfy. So I might actually prefer that one, you just don't know. But for £11, I really hope the other one fits, because bargain. It should have been like £34 or £35. So good. So I got it for £11. Let's hope it fits. Cross your fingers that it fits. Really hope it fits. Right now, I think I'm going to go have a bath. I've been in quite a lot of pain today and like been really, really uncomfortable. So I think I literally just need to go and lie in a hot bath and kind of just do nothing and lie in the bath. So I'm going to go do that and watch some YouTube on my phone, I think, while I'm in there just relaxing everything. And yeah, so that is what I am going to go do. I think I'm as uncomfortable as I am today because I was running around with Daniel's nephew, so kind of my nephew, yesterday, and he has so much energy, it's insane. And so I kind of really ache and hurt today. And then have an early night. Although it's 9 o'clock now, so probably won't have an early night because I'll probably be in the bath for like an hour. So I really hope you guys all had a really good Friday and I hope you're looking forward to your weekend. Let me know what your weekend plans were in the comments below. What did you get up to this weekend? Did you go out? Did you have a night in? Did you have some girlfriends over? What did you do? Did you go and see Beauty and the Beast? I still haven't seen Beauty and the Beast. I think myself and some girls at work are going to plan a trip to go and see Beauty and the Beast. We're going to go for dinner and then go and see it. So I'm really excited for that. I watched Cinderella the other day because I still hadn't watched that, like the like real version, if that makes sense, like the human version. That makes no sense, but you know what I mean. I watched that the other day and I really liked that. I absolutely loved Helena Bonham Carter in it. I love her in anything. Like, she's my favorite in Sweeney Todd, like everything that she's in, The Corpse Bride, like literally I love her. Love her, she's one of my favourite actresses ever. And then her and Johnny Depp together are just dreams, let's be honest. Oh, are you done now? Look at the footprints she leaves everywhere. Bye. Oh, we're white! Well, my Saturday started well. There's no hot water, so I can't have a shower. So, yay, I feel gross. I'm going to have to whack like gallons of dry shampoo in this mop. brilliant start to a Saturday. I've done what I can. I feel like hideous. Does anyone else feel like that? Like when they feel like they just really want a shower and they just can't have one. I could have one, but it'd have to be in cold water, and I'm already in quite a lot of pain today, and adding cold water to that would just be a disaster waiting to happen. Like it will happen and I like won't be able to move. I'd be in so much pain if I did that. So it's better for me to just not even tempt it. Really itchy ears today. Is that a thing? Really itchy ears. Time to go and buy my mama some flowers for Mother's Day. I was gonna say Valentine's Day then. What? Mother's Day. It's gonna take me a little while to walk around. I'm in so much pain today. Not having a shower this morning has made such like a bad difference to how I feel, because I felt so bad anyway and I'm worse in the morning, so I kind of need that hot water when I'm really bad and I couldn't have it. So it's gonna take me a little while to walk around, I think. I'm gonna go and look on the market because the market has some really pretty flowers, and if I can't find anything there, I'm gonna go into Marks and Spencer's because they've always got good flowers in Marks and Spencer's. I'm also thinking maybe a pot plant because then it will last forever, whereas like normal flowers die, obviously. Well done, Cara, stating the obvious there. But a pot plant, she can obviously keep forever. So let's go find some flowers. Need a vase for the flowers. I got some tulips. These are for me though. How pretty are they? So pretty, and they're really short stems as well, so hopefully they won't droop as quick. But I got Mum a little pink rose in a pot, so she can keep it forever and she can plant it if she wants. Aren't I cute? So cute. Every time I see Alice on Twitter or anything like that, she makes me want Watsits, so I went to get Watsits because I saw a tweet. I'm home, here are my tulips. They're so pretty. And then I'll show you Mum's little rose plant too. This is what I got her. So I was like, she can keep it then and like plant it in a pot or something and always have it. And then these are what Chris has got her. So pretty. I love flowers. Flowers make me so happy. I've got pizza for dinner. Ham and pineapple, one of my faves, not gonna lie. Lots of people don't like ham and pineapple pizza, but I really do. So that's what I've got for dinner tonight. And I'm gonna sit and eat that while I edit the weekly vlog, which I think is gonna be quite short this week. I was thinking about it today, and I was like, I don't think I've actually like vlogged that much this week, which is really bad. But we'll see. I need to clean up my mess. I've just left my mess here, sorting my tulips out. Yeah, so I just need to write in Mum's card, and then I'm gonna set it up with, I'll take the price off for the flowers, probably a good idea. And then set it all up, because I'm not gonna see her tomorrow because I'm at work. So I'll see her in the evening, but I kind of want her to get them like tonight or in the morning, so I might just give them to her tonight. So yeah, I'm gonna put my pizza in and I'm gonna start editing the vlog. Does anyone else go to like close the app they're on and lock their phone and end up doing it at the same time and taking a screenshot of their like app? I just did that, so now I have a picture of Twitter in my photo feed that I need to delete. The vlog's longer than I thought it was going to be, so you've got a normal length vlog. I actually vlogged slightly more than I thought, which is good. Oh, that cat, seriously. I'm so jealous of her. I want to go to bed now. It's 9:10 now and the clocks go forward. Yeah, forward tonight. So I'm going to lose an hour. So technically it's like 10:10. So I should be going to bed and I can't because I haven't quite finished editing the vlog yet. I don't know if you can hear Chris. He's quite loud tonight. Probably you can't. You probably can't. I keep looking at these as well and they make me really happy. They're so cute. I love flowers. They're really wedged in that vase actually though, because there's a lot of tulips there for the size of the vase, but that's the biggest vase I have. Can I just say, before we end this vlog, thank you so much for all of your comments on last week's vlog. There were so many of you guys that commented and it made me so happy, you have no idea. I absolutely love receiving comments, like I said last week. They make me really, really happy. And I love having like little chats with you guys. So keep them coming, like keep the comments coming. I absolutely love it. And quickly before my battery dies, because my battery is flashing, I will end this vlog. I really hope you enjoyed the vlog. It's been a quiet week with a few exciting bits in between. Next week we've got a IKEA trip coming up with my brother and his new housemate, because they will be moving into their house next week. Although I don't know if Chris is moving, but I know his housemate is going to be moving. They get keys on Wednesday, basically. So we're having an IKEA trip, so that's really exciting because I bloomin' love IKEA. It's one of my favourite places to go, and I will be having IKEA meatballs for dinner. I can tell you that now. So you don't miss that, make sure you subscribe, click on my face, it'll be up here somewhere at some point in the next few minutes or seconds, however long I talk for. Leave me a comment down below, like I just said. Let me know what happened in your week. Did anything exciting happen in your week? Was it a boring week like mine? Was it a normal boring week like mine? Still haven't heard anything else about the house, unfortunately. I think we are in for a bit of a wait with this one. I'm hoping it's gonna be worth the wait when we get the house. I don't wanna have to like sit and wait for 2 weeks and then not get the house. I guess we'll just have to keep our hopes up and fingers crossed and toes crossed and tongues twisted and what else? And just hope that I get the house. So yes, I really hope you enjoyed the vlog. Give it a thumbs up if you did, and I will see you next week. I feel like Chris whenever I say that, and I will see you next time. Or goes, what does he do? What does he do? I will see you tomorrow. Something like that. I don't know. I've heard it so many times, it's kind of gone.